So, idea of building a Möbius bridge. Now, one problem is that if you make a band, you're supposed to walk on that band across the bridge, and that band slowly turns, well, at the end of the bridge, you're falling into the water. That's no good, right? However, if you make your band kind of a cross-section, not like a crescent, and then you can move that cross-section, you know, through 180 degree, and you still have a place to stand on from one end to the other. So basically, you can kind of look down these pathways, and as you walk across and you're nice and on the horizontal surface, you simply find that that crescent rotates around you. And first you have your wall on the right-hand side, and then you have it on your left-hand side, but you can still walk across straight. And then you simply complete the loop over the top and make sure that in doing so, the whole thing closes up on itself, so it forms an overall Möbius band. And the hallmark of the Möbius band is you start on this side and you walk around, and you walk around on the inside, and you walk around on the inside, and you're suddenly on the other side on that top loop.
Okay. And you could, but you could still put this over a river like a bridge.
This, as is, you know, would certainly function like a bridge, right?
Cool.
Well, it's just one of several possible designs.
Wow.
Here is a Möbius band. You can see it has this one twist. And this is very simple. It basically, you're walking on this pretty much flat surface. And then the twist actually happens on the return path. And it essentially turns vertical. And that allows you to essentially support that particular bridge. Or, if you don't want to use it as a structural support that supports from below, you could flip this thing over and use it that way, okay? And now you're walking on the silver surface here, but now, of course, you have a tunnel through your structural support, but that might be aesthetically more interesting or more pleasing. So I think another totally practical way of building a Möbius bridge.
I'm surprised people aren't building these. They're brilliant. Well, maybe they. Do you know of anyone building these yet?
There was one built not too long ago in Bristol, and you have to look a little bit.
In Bristol.
Yep, better go check it out.
I will.
Yes. So they're supposedly having. I've only have seen pictures of it. But it looks like it's an honest to God Möbius bridge, even though it's kind of a flamboyant return path that makes most of the twisting, and it's sort of a horizontal loop like that. I think a more elegant and really structural, simple Möbius bridge would be this one here. Again, we can look and you can see where you walk through or where you drive through, that is very simple, straight pathways. So all the Möbius twist essentially happens in that loop over the top. You can see as the flat band that forms the rod bed goes up over the top, it makes a 180 degree flip and comes back to the other side. And that makes a perfect vertically oriented arch that is strong enough so it can act as a suspension bridge. So it can actually hang the roadway, you know, from the vertical arch that is oriented in the right way to give you maximal strength. What about Möbius houses?
Yes.
Yeah, they're coming up. So I claim both of these are Möbius houses. Now, what's happening with all the color? Let's look at this one first. Is it a Möbius band? Well, we have to kind of start up here. We're running down there. We're running around the bottom. We're coming up the other side. And yes, indeed, we're on the other side. So that tells us this is indeed a Möbius band. Does it make a practical house? Oh, I think we orient it like that. There are houses that are slanted, like the towers in Madrid, for instance, right? So there's nothing novel there. You probably would have to either run the elevator at an angle, which you can certainly do with a special track. So the question is, okay, all the green stuff may be windows, okay, and you have a lot of good office space and, you know, maybe apartments and the like that have, you know, perfect views. But then down here, to be consistent, the green stuff is on top. Well, what does that mean? Well, that's where you put your lobby, that's where you put your cafeteria, that's where you put your library, and they all want skylights. On the top of the flat part at the bottom, we essentially have a glass ceiling, and it nicely transitions into the vertical part of the glass, which gives you the ordinary windows that you might find in your office or in your apartment. Here is another very obvious Möbius band. Same idea. We have very straight, very conventional, you know, a building block, you know, with maybe three, four stories worth of apartments or hotel rooms or whatever. And then a much larger flat part along the bottom, just as before. That's where we might have, you know, the lobbies and the restaurants and the meeting rooms and the ballrooms and the library and stuff like that. So again, I think in both of these instances, these are Möbius buildings that really, there's no doubt that they're Möbius bands and they're very practical. And from what I've seen by famous architects kind of thinking about Möbius houses, it's of much less obvious how they might function. And for me, it was not always obvious to even see that there indeed are Möbius configurations.
We've got to get one of these things built. You've got to get a grant and get one made.
Yep. Well, somehow this doesn't want to come
apart
here.
This thing,
okay, if you look at that, then it still hangs together. It seems to be like one band. Actually, it's a band that goes around the loop twice and seems to be somewhat intertwined.